Oh shit. I might not have recorded our. Might not have recorded our class. Alright.
Thank you. find the limit of what I can see. I murder my son with a passion and you find out that that's how I said I saved him.
I don't know.
Okay. All right, shall we carry on? So I just checked. So I did stop the recording at some point, but I've restarted it. It looks like it might have copied and kept all of it. But it's not actually recording the video at all. It just records the audio, which is pretty useless. I'll have to experiment with that a bit more. We'll just see how we go. Okay, so we finished off, we were just talking about this, and I've left a little brain teaser for you and said, well, now we know from Ohm's law that resistance equals voltage over current. I'm telling you that's true. And we know that this is 50 volt supply, and we must have 15 amps as our total current, because we worked out the individual currents there. So if I go 50 divided by 15, I get 3.33, so that's going to be my total resistance. Anyone want to go out on a limb and see if they can tell me why? Any ideas at all? What's happened there? How is my resistance, total resistance, less than the resistance of each of those individual resistances? Yes, and what does that mean? It means I can get more flow, right? If we think of our water pipes again and we go, okay, I've restricted each of these so they can only have 15 litres per minute, or 5 litres per minute, my main line coming in can give me 15 litres per minute. Then actually, if you add those three split lines together, they must be as big as the main line coming in, right? Because they're taking 15 amps total between the three of them. So the total resistance must be less than the individual resistances. That makes sense, right? Am I, everybody with me on that one? The total resistance in a parallel circuit must be less than the individual resistors. It must be, in fact, less than the smallest resistor, if they're all different. Because that smallest resistor, whatever it is, if it's 1 ohm, it's going to let through a certain amount of current. But then I'm going to add some more lines on top of that. So the total resistance must be less than the lowest resistor. Everyone comfortable with that? Does it make sense? So how do we work it out? There's a very obvious relationship between this number here and those three resistors. What is that relationship? Yep. And? Each of them are 10 ohms. And 10 divided by 3 resistors is what? 3.3333, or 3 and a third. And again, we've already demonstrated, worked out ourselves, that if I have any number of resistors in a circuit that are the same, then I can just divide that resistance, whatever the resistance of each individual one is, by the number of resistors. So I could say if I added another one on top of there, another 10 ohm resistor, what's my total resistance going to be? 2.5, yeah, because now I've got 4 10 ohm resistors, 10 divided by 4 is 2.5. What if the resistors weren't all the same? What if the resistors weren't all the same? Yeah. Okay, good idea. Let's think about that for a second. So I said that the total resistance must be less than the lowest resistor. And that makes sense, right? Because whatever that lowest resistance is, it's going to carry a certain amount of current. As soon as I put another parallel line, even if that parallel line has a very high resistance, it's still going to slightly decrease my total resistance, right? Because I'm adding another line. Does that make sense? Okay. So if we took your example, then let's throw some numbers at it. I've got two resistors. One of them's 10 ohms, one of them's 1 ohm. So we know from what I've just said, we explained, that the total resistance must be less than, and the lowest is 1. So the total resistance must be less than 1. But if I add them together and divide it by 2, what do I get? So, excellent theory. I love that you're thinking out there and trying to figure out what the answer is. But in this case, we can very quickly prove that, no, it can't be that. No, I'm not, but I was just going to say, I'm not going to ask you to figure it out because it's quite a complicated formula. That's why it's not complicated, it's not intuitive. But is anyone who want to throw out a guess anyway? Well, I'm hoping through the magic of shared brain power that the very next slide is going to tell me the answer. Ah, there we go. Excellent. I love it when the plan comes together. So, in a parallel circuit, the total resistance, how good is that, actually? Because we stuck on one slide for nearly an hour there and went through all of this other stuff, and then we got stuck. The very last thing is, how do we work out the total resistance? Boom, next slide. Here it is. Total resistance can be calculated using 1 over RT equals 1 over R1 plus 1 over R2 plus 1 over R3. Oh, no, right there. You're all looking at it going, what? Yeah, this is where it starts to get a little bit fishy. So we're talking about the reciprocal value. Or another way to do it, and in fact, the easiest way to do it, I think, on your calculator, is instead of 1 over, you use to the power of negative 1. So another way of doing it in your calculator would be RT equals R1 to the negative 1 plus R2 to the negative 1 plus R3 to the negative 1. And in fact, that should work even if we use that example of 3 10 ohm resistors. So let's start with that one. See if you can work that out using either one of those formulas there. If you're going to do this, then you're probably best to do this, brackets on your calculator, like that. If you're using this one, then you just need brackets like that. That's the reason why I think this one is easier. So let's see if we can work it out using 10 ohms as the resistors. We already know what the answer is. We've already worked it out. Let's see if you can use that formula and get that answer. Go, go, go. I'm guessing the reason it didn't record my video is it doesn't know which video to record. It could be anyone. It's just recording the whole meeting. So how do I make it record my video? Anyone? I think that might be the answer. I have to sit down tonight and do a bit of Googling, see where I can figure out. What's that? I only heard of it when we went into the last lockdown, and this was how we did all our team meetings and stuff. We use all the Microsoft stuff like Office, and so this is part of it. But I kind of understand that it doesn't know who to record, but there must be a way to tell it. I don't know what it is. It's pretty useless if we can't see. Yeah, so because I recorded a small bit before and apparently I accidentally turned it off, or somebody else might have turned it off, that might be another downfall. I'm not sure if you guys could actually stop the recording, which would be a nightmare. If anyone's just slightly gone and turned the recording off, it's definitely Ollie. I don't know, why are you, Ollie? Just feels right. Take the time, team, to work this out, whether you're using your phone or your calculator or even your Google calculator on the computer. Please take the time to work through this, because it's really important you understand how to use this formula. Again, like I said earlier, that it's not super complicated, but actually putting it into a calculator and getting the right result might take a little bit of trial and error to get the brackets in the right place and that kind of thing. I've actually found in the past that's probably the hardest thing about this formula is, you don't want to be sitting in a test and know the formula, but you're still getting the wrong answers because you're not putting in the calculator properly. Make sense? So take the opportunity now.
Oh, yeah, that one.
You know what the answer is, so you can just start a micro average and you get the right answer.
If you want to
do like anyone else. You start remaining with your video disabled. Oh, Do you know where that came from? That is a company's logo. I shit you not. It's a company called Wine Friend. It's like a subscription service. You pay money per month and they send you boxes of wine. Yep. And then, so one day my mate was at the home show, just about 3 years ago, and he, he took a photo. They had a stand there and he took a photo and he's like, right, your face is on this company's thing. I sent them a message on Facebook. I sent them a photo of myself and I was like, you stole my face. Give it back. But then I thought, well, I'm stealing their logo and I use that as my thing. It's funny. Oh, there you go. You can say, my lecturer is the guy on your box. Well, then we can go to court and we can say, well, my face existed before your logo. So, you know, it was funny. So just the other day, could be, but it's pretty generic. I've had about 3 or 4 people send me random photos of similar sorts of things, and they'd be like, oh, this company's using a face. But here's a funny thing. So literally the other day, I went, like that day we were, the day that we were at, we went to the, what was it, the barbecue thing at North Campus?
Yeah,
I had to pick up a new phone, work one. And I walked in there and they had somebody there, as obviously a subscriber, so they had the Wine Friend box on the front desk. And I was looking at it, I was going, there's that bloody box, there's my face. And then the dude who had my phone, I said to the receptionist, I got to talk to Chris. And she goes, I'll ring him and get him to come down. So he comes out, first thing he says to me, bro, you look just like your profile picture. And I said, you know where I got it from? He's like, where? I said, there, look, there's a box on the desk. Like, there's my face. There is that pic. There you go. That's it right there. It's strange, isn't it? I've just got a generic face. People want to use it as a logo.
And
oh, yeah. Okay, I'm just gonna leave this meeting for a minute to try something. Hopefully it doesn't